Well, good morning, mattressing fans. Something a bit different today. We're actually going out on a practice session. I'm joining my good friend Rob Wotton on the bank of Woodland View today. I'm going to shoot to his house, jump in his van. We're going to have a little talk about tactics and whatnot. And then we're going to head over to Woodland View. Reason for our visit? Well, we've got the Preston Pole Fishing Pairs final this weekend coming up. And to be honest, we just wanted a bit of a cheeky practice. It's a great opportunity to get some video stuff and obviously a bit of a feature as well, but you know, more importantly, we're going to get a chance to have a little look at the fishing. Word on the street is that it's pretty hard, actually. We've got, you know, it's on the lakes that I'm going on, which is front and back Deans. It's a lot of pinky fishing, small roach, that sort of thing, with maybe an odd bonus fish, maybe a carp, maybe a bream, maybe a few F1s. So, you know, go have a look there today and try and sort that out. But Rob's on High and Isles, which are fishing much better. But like I say, we're going to head over to his, if he can get out of bed, and we'll see what, you know, we can see what he thinks of the situation. But yeah, this is going to be a monthly thing with Rob. Both myself and Rob are going to go out on the bank somewhere, have a little practice session, load of fun, load of laughs, and also catch a few fish, and hopefully you can learn a few bits as well. So stay tuned, and we'll head off over to Rob's house now.
Right, we're all loaded up. We've got loads of bait, loads of tackle with us, ready for a really good practice session. I'll just turn that radio down. We're going to head over to Rob's house now. Like I say, hopefully be out of bed. I mean, it is 20 past 8 in the morning, so you'd hope he'd be up by now, wouldn't you? So yeah, let's head over there now and see what Rob's got to say for himself.
Right, ladies and gentlemen, those of you that know me will know I don't particularly like getting up early in the morning. But it's okay today because we're going fishing. Joe's going to come around here, we're going to load my van up, we're going to bomb off to Woodlands View. Now, neither of us have been to Woodlands View for quite a while, so we need a bit of practice for this weekend's pole pairs final. Now, all I've got to do is get Trumpy Pants ready for school. He's got to eat his breakfast, which is shredded wheat. I've got to eat my banana. And then get him on the scooter, off to school. Hopefully by that time Joe's here, load the van and we're off fishing.
Simple. There he is, look. Right.
You don't wake up, have you?
Hey.
Not been tapped on the door?
No.
I've been asleep all day.
No, Woodland View is a good little venue, isn't it, to be fair?
Yeah, it's a brilliant venue.
You like it, don't you?
Yeah, but it's hard.
It's hard. Very hard at the moment.
What won the lake last week? £6.
£6, I'm going on front and back Deans.
Yeah.
£6 won my lake.
Which isn't very good, is it? That's good.
It's not very good, is it? Especially given that everywhere's fishing really well at the minute.
Yeah.
But I think even though it's £6, I think it still brings a few bites.
Yeah.
A lot of small fish.
Yeah, there's loads of little tiny fish.
Little tiny fish.
But anyway, you're going on them lakes, aren't you?
I'm going on the boring lakes.
You'll go on the boring lakes where it's canal fishing. I'll go on the lakes where we're canal
fishing. Hang on, you're
the
canal angler.
I can't remember. Well, yeah, last time I fished a canal there, I caught
yesterday.
A carp. No, I caught a carp.
Yesterday.
Yeah, yesterday, but I was fishing.
Chucking, still going on a canal every day.
Chucking rubber crayfish out of a perch.
Yeah. Yeah, I suppose.
Can't use rubber crayfish on Saturday, can we?
No. Can't use barb jig heads either.
No.
You can actually fish lures here, can't you?
Yeah, they're lure matches.
Lure matches.
There you go.
So what's going to happen on your lakes then?
What's going to happen on my lakes?
Have you got any worms?
No. Zubi muffins. What's going to happen on my lakes?
You're going to tap some maggots in and catch a load, aren't you?
I'm going to tap some maggots in. Because obviously F1's count. What did you say about carp? £100?
Yeah, it's looking like a change to the rules. Because there's so many little tiny carp,
yeah,
and they feel like it's just going to be a nightmare.
Because he's just stopped it, isn't it, with little carp?
They're just going to allow everything under £1.
And I remember last year when I fished with Lee Kerris.
Yeah, name drop there.
Name drop. Bang, Lee Kerris straight in. I caught...
think I was I second at the whole of Woodlands View. Lee was second at the whole of Laugh at the Lane.
Great performance, wasn't it?
And we still didn't win. But that's by the by. He walked round and there was sort of, oh, is that an F1? Is that a car?
Yeah,
there was a bit of like, I haven't got a clue. This, today will be.
This is a blank canvas for you, isn't it?
This is a blank canvas for me. Today will be the first time.
What wins?
Things have got exciting around here. Today will be the first time I've got my kit out and fish sort of
a bit competitively. More,
yeah, competitively for like 2 months.
Good that.
I've hibernated in the winter.
You've probably missed out on the worst time though, to be fair.
Yeah, I do, yeah, of course so. Yeah, I'm not going this summer, am I?
I don't know.
Stuff. There you are. Who's this? Paul.
Hey?
Paul, should we talk to Paul? Paul?
Hi mate, alright.
Yeah, good.
Where are you on the way out?
We're going, me and Joe are going Woodlands View for practice. Me and Joe, Port, you're breaking up, I'll speak to you later. That's good then. I think last time I come here was with Lee last year.
Where did you draw then? Arles?
Arles. Can't remember the peg.
A decent day's fishing though, wasn't it?
Terrible with pegs.
Okay, that's a bit of thatching.
Nice thatch.
Nice thatch there, look. Joe Thornton, master thatcher. Great guy.
I can't remember the peg I was on. A big 28 pounds.
You have some tenge?
No.
Crusions?
F1s.
No.
F1s, tapping maggots in. And then I caught some late chucking casters short, which, let's get right, that's all I'm going to do.
That's your game,
that's
isn't it?
That's me. No matter what we learn today, I'm going to tap maggots in long and chuck casters short, no matter what I learn today.
What about pinkies? I told you last night, I'd started tying up some size 22 hooks and what the hell are you doing? Why are you doing that?
Looks nice, Rob.
No wind.
Hey, up.
Kid there, fishing. Should be at school.
Yeah, should be, shouldn't it? What's that all about?
Peg One Angling Centre.
Where are we going then? Over there?
Yeah, we might as well park around the back, haven't we?
Or should we go and have a chat?
We'll go and say hello.
Pull up hard to pull right outside to impose yourself on people.
Right, Smokey, your peg looks okay. Drizzling. But it's calm. So I think you can work something out.
Compared to Storm Doris days.
Yeah, I think you'll be able to work something out. I think, to be fair, it looks pretty bleak. It's not the lake I'd choose to fish, but...
Yeah, but it's fishing, isn't it?
It's fishing. I think you'll enjoy it in some weird...
Well,
sad
I'm like
way.
That, aren't
yeah,
I?
You're a bit of a.
I'm a bit of a saddo.
And my lake looks quite nice. I think ours is a nice lake. Nice old looking lake. I'm happy with it.
It is a nice lake, ours, isn't it?
And I think I'm fishing for better quality fish, aren't I, compared to you?
I think you're fishing for F1s, Crusians, that sort of thing.
Yeah, and you're fishing
better
for
rope.
Little tiny fish and then hoping for a run of F1s later on.
A bream maybe or two.
All I know is. I can't use my ground bait.
So before,
I can't use my pellets.
Simstim Green, Marine Halibut, and 2mm dynamite pellets, none of which we can use.
And hemp, we've got some hemp.
Hemp, yeah.
Yeah, none of which we can use. So
that's good, that's a good bucket to bring that.
So the best thing we can do is I'll get my kit on the peg and then I can come over to you and scrounge as much bait as I possibly can.
Yeah, all right. Let's get unloaded.
Oh,
some big.
I've got
loads of rigs, look. Rigs for days. Oh. Rigs. Don't need them here, do I? Got rigs, haven't I? Taking this event seriously, Rob. How's your kit getting on? Are you set up yet? Right, well, I don't know about Rob, but I'm getting ready to go, so I think he's still fanning about making rigs up and whatnot. But I've just decided on a simple approach. I'm going to fish just fluoro pinkies, hopefully catch some like roach and small fish. I'm going to feed them at about 11 metres where I can just nicely fire them with a catapult. And I've been tipped off that the fish in this lake particularly are really, really scatty, so I'm going to feed three lines at 40.5 metres. All I'm going to feed that with is really finely minced up chopped worms, just small amounts, maybe a few casters, an odd maggot, and maybe fish a single red maggot over the top, try and catch an odd skimmer. I think it's going to be really hard on this lake. Maybe not today because I'm sat here on my own, but certainly in the match I think it's going to be quite difficult. So I've just set up a couple of rigs, just keeping it simple. I just want to focus on the baits and the feeding really rather than rigs today. So all I've got is a 4x12 Preston Silvers float, and that's started with a Bulk and three droppers and a size 20 PR412 hook. And then I've got the same rig but in a 4x10 size with strung out shot, so I can have a nice slow fall of the hook bait. Both top kits are with, you know, original slip 5 through a full top kit, nice and soft. Hopefully you should be able to land anything a hook with that set up really. Just nice and simple, nice and soft. I think, you know, £10 would be really, really, really good on this lake. So, you know, if I do hook a cruising or a tench, I just want to take my time and get it out. The last thing I want to do is bump anything. So, yeah, that's my thing. I'm going to get some bait together, get some bait fed, and then I'll leave it over to Rob to show you what he's doing.
Right, so we're all set up. Now, when it comes to practicing, I like to do things a little bit differently. Now, I know Smokey will probably want to fish 2-3 lines and fish today as he's fishing a match. To me, because it's quite a relaxed practice session, I want to just pick a line to start with and just fish that line. I want to see how the fish react to what I'm doing on that one particular line. And by doing that, then I can alter things during the day and try different things out. So I can use the lessons that I've learned on that one line and try them out elsewhere in the peg. Now, I've got about 4.5-5 foot at 40.5 metres. I've set up quite a light float. There's not a ripple on the water today, so I've set up a 4x12 duster. Just fishing with strung number 11 stots. I've got an 8-inch hook length of 08 with a size 18, and I've got a gamma green on. I think it's a really, really sharp, fine hook. But importantly, with a soft elastic, I've got a number soft 6 on today. Still get out, you know, most of your bigger fish that you hook. As I say, 40.5 metres is the line I've chose. I'm going to just drip in a few maggots there to start with and just see how things go. I'm going to ease myself into the session. That brings me onto the bait. Now, I've got some empty bait tins here. Joe's got all the bait. I'm going to have to go on the scrounge. So let's go and get a few maggots.
Right, here we go. Like I said, Rob's messing about, he's just doing his little intro. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to feed my swim. So all I'm going to do, I'm going to put in just, I don't know, 100 pinkies or so on that 11 metre line. Let's get them in there. And it's really important, I think, that I can loose feed this. So I'm going to actually feed it quite a bit short. Line up my far bank marker. And just to make sure, pick up a few pinkies with my catapult and loose feed, and just to make sure I can get them there. See, I can get them there nicely. Yeah, that's nice, that. Right, let's feed them longer lines. I think these could be the important swims today, just to get an odd bigger fish. I'm gonna feed it ever so negative. Don't see the point. I'm just gonna put in, I don't know, what's that, 30 casters? Really tiny amount of chopped worms, a few maggots. I'm going to top them up quite regular. Oh, the sun's coming out, how nice. And what I've done, I've picked three, it's really nice here actually, because you get areas of dark with light water, so I'm going to pot in that one there, right in line with that. Put the same in on another line. See, it's quite interesting because me and Rob are going to have to fish totally different matches if we're going to do any good here. Because there's a lot more quality fish in the lakes where Rob's going to be fishing. And mine's going to be more about building a weight with smaller fish and smaller weights. So I really need to cover my options a little bit. And finally, in fact, no, I'm going to feed a bit more on this one. Let's put a bit more bait in. One positive one. Over to my right. So I've got two negative ones and a positive one. So that's three lines at 40.5 metres. Just put that one in there. Now I'm going to keep topping these up. That's nice, that. And I may even throw, in fact, I'm going to pot some casters in short. Just just to give me the option of dropping on that late, because I've been told by my good friend Adrian Whittle that there is a chance of an odd better fish late on shore on Caster, so I've got to bear that in mind. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to pot in a couple of hundred casters on a short line. Where shall I do this? Slightly to my there, I think. Yeah. Again, just want to make sure I can feed them by hand. Yeah, nice. See Rob's set up. So, let's slip a pinky on, see if we can get a bite. I'm going to start on the heavier rig. 4x12. Just really about feeling my way into the session, really. Just got a single pinky on there, you see that? Nicely on that size 20 hook. Let's see if we can get a bite. Fully expecting to catch a roach pretty soon on this. But let's just see what we can do. Need some bait, do you?
Yeah, get some bait.
There's some casters open there.
Where?
There.
You're not going to need all that, are you?
No, there's some casters open there, look. I had a bite as soon as I dropped in and not had a sighting.
Haven't you?
No. And then there's some maggots and pinkies in that bucket.
No, will I?
No, you won't need many, will you?
Pine.
Eh?
Pine there.
Yeah.
You got some worms?
Yeah. Why do you want some? You don't want some.
A couple of pinkies in there, some maggots.
Yeah, they're in that bucket behind you.
What about the maggots?
Yeah, they're in the bucket behind you. There's a tub there ready for you.
Nice.
They're my bait tubs.
No, it's my bait tubs.
Oh, they?
Not ponds and everything.
Just
bait.
Just bait.
Right, we're ready to start. As I say, I'm just going to take a softly approach on one line. What I'm going to do is start by tapping in a few maggots, probably 6, 7, 8 maggots, out of a little pole-mounted pot. It's just a little cad pot, and I've just hashed across the top with some pole elastic, and it means that it's easy to put the maggots in, but they're not going to fall out as I'm shipping out. And every time I tap in, probably 3 or 4 will fall out. I can turn the pot back over, tap again, 3 or 4 more will fall out. I think I'll start on a maggot and a pinky. I like tipping the maggot with a pinky. I just think that extra, that pink colour adds a bit of brightness. Just something else to the bait. A few maggots in the pot. As I say, I've plumbed up at 14.5 metres. Got a nice marker on the far side, it's a bull rush down the other end of the lake. One tap, a few maggots fall in. Might have to get a cap out of the car, the sun's a bit naughty. Nice light rig. I think it's important, especially early on while the weather's calm as well, just to start on a light rig, just to see what's going on in the swim, because if this rig gets held up by small fish straight away, or if there's a bit of tow on, because there's an aerator just probably 20 metres away, that could be creating a bit of tow, I'll be able to see everything on this light rig. Whereas if I just went out maybe with a 0.5 gram rig straight away, I don't think I wouldn't see everything straight away. It'd take me a bit longer to work things out. So just starting with a light rig and then I'll take it from there.
I'm waiting. Another one. Maybe that's the way. Tiny little bit, as predicted. Tiny little roach, ounce a piece probably. But it's bites.
There we go, another roach.
On the fall, but I'm just going to pick that 4x10 rig up because it's noticeable that, you know, the bites are very delicate. So if you pick that light rig up, they might just have it on the fall. That one's got strung out shots, totally different to the other one. Again, 5 elastic, which I think is probably quite nice for this sort of fishing.
not too light. We don't want anything too faffy. We want to just get on with it. Let's get this 4x10 out. I think this could be the rig, to be honest. Given what I've seen now with the size of fish and the way the bite's coming on the fall, this tiny rig might just be the one. So we'll just hang on to that and let it fall nice and slowly. Let's see if this 4x10 float does the damage, so to speak. There we go, straight under. See, that was lovely. Just settled and went straight under, just as you'd expect when pinky fishing. They're only small fish, but that is what I think I'm going to need to target on this lake to start with anyway.
I like to just keep laying the rig in every now and again. I don't like it sitting in the same place for ages and ages. I think that falling bait attracts a fish. If, just as your hook bait falls, I think fish sort of follow it down, just take it just as it settles. This way of fishing is all about building the swim up. It's not about a gung-ho approach where you fill it in with bait and then hope that fish turn up. It's all about building a peg. So I don't expect it to be a brilliant start, but I do expect it to get better as the day goes on.
First sort of better fish of the session. Not a massive fish, of course, but on these commercial silverfish matches, any sort of better fish is a very, very, very welcome bonus, and it's a nice little hybrid. Look at that. Catch a few of them on the day, they'll be more than welcome.
There you go, there's a little fish. If I can nick the odd couple of fish early on, hopefully slightly bigger than this one, and build the peg as the day goes on, I'll be quite happy with that. To be fair, obviously it's a silvers only match. If I can catch, what's that, 2 ounce fish? If I can catch one of those every chuck, I'll be quite happy. So you can see they're obviously coming to a few maggots. So I think what I'll do the same thing again and just see how it goes. Obviously if I get pestered by small fish all day, and the beauty of being in a match situation is you can see what's going on around you. So you can see if other people are starting to catch slightly better fish and you're falling behind. If I keep getting pestered by them small fish and people are catching bigger fish, then obviously it's probably time to do something with my feed, probably up the feed or change what I'm feeding. But for now, we'll just keep tapping in a few maggots. Okay. Obviously with this pot you tap in 4 or 5 and then fish the rig for a little bit. Hopefully you get a bite. If not, you tap in 4 or 5 more and then fish your feed out.
Right, well, I've just carried on going. I've just had that hybrid. And I just hooked into another better fish, which there's an odd little bubble coming up in my swim, which I assume skimmers. I think this is another one. It's a better fish, this is. Oh yeah, nice fish. Just loose feeding them pinkies. There we go. Look at him, beauty. Look at that. Great start. There we go. Another skimmer, maybe. Yeah. Maybe a bream. Oh, a good fish this is. Tiniest indication on the float, it just lifted up. Quarter of an inch, and that's what this fishing's all about. You know, you've got tiny little indications, light floats, little hooks, and you're just trying to make the most of every little bite, every little indication. Could be a big perch, this. I know there's plenty of them in here. Interesting, that pinky's got us off to a good start. You know, bearing in mind 10 pounds probably going to be my target, you know, if I land this. If it's not a carp, of course, then that'll be. Oh, I think it is a carp. I think I've just seen it. Was it an F1? Could be an F1. Oh, it's a big, dirty, great big F1. See, now these count on the day.
Rob.
Look at that. F1? Yeah. It's a lovely big F1. Just lip up there. I mean, he's £3 of anybody's money. So, very interesting that. Right, we just had a bit of a turn up for the books. Didn't, unfortunately, didn't get it on my big camera. But hopefully, a bit of GoPro footage will just show you. We just had a nice F1 on the Pinky Swim, which there's always that opportunity here at Woodland View. There's plenty of them. But I didn't expect it, I've got to be honest. Thought we'd really not even see a better fish like that on this swim, especially. So I'm just feeding, let's say, 10 pinkies. Not really mixing it up just yet, because I'm just trying to build on it. But it's really got me thinking that, because that was £3, that fish. And with them counting, you know, I've got £5 in the net already. You know, £10 probably going to be my target. Now, I know we're sat here on our own, but that's one F1. And 5 hours is a long time. I'd fancy catching an F1 or two in 5 hours, I've got to be honest. But these are nice, these dumpy roach. There's plenty of these here, it seems. Not solid, but it's nice fishing. You know, your float's going in, settling, sitting there for a few seconds, and then going under. We just flick that rig over. Same again. Just 10 pinkies. Nicely loose fed. I think if the wind was strong, I'd probably be tempted to pop these in, actually. I'm just feeding that short line, keeping casters going in. Now, I know, I remember fishing on here once, many years ago, on the last time I fished a silverfish match on these lakes. I ended up catching some really big bream down the edge. It was quite windy. I was actually on Bat Dean's that day. And I caught some big bream down the edge, and it was similar. There was no cover, but it's the only place where you can get in a shallower depth of water. So I've got that in my back of my mind, thinking, well, there could be a place for an edge approach. Just throw some casters or something, just out the way. Oh, here we go, another roach. Whizzing the pole back. A nice fish. He's not a swinger. Lovely. Lovely roach. Look at him. Beautiful fish.
So this time, I'm just going to slowly start upping the feed. So we've got 12 or 13 maggots now going in the pot. Try not to spread them out as I'm shipping out. Sun's a bit of a nuisance. Sun's ever so bright. Bite on the drop. Same result, tiny fish. I think I've just got to plough through these and just hope that some better fish start feeding. Really filled the pot this time with maggots, just to try and get some bait to the bottom. If I'm hooking a fish a foot under the surface with a sort of a rig that's got a few shot on it, I imagine that all those maggots that are falling at a really slow rate are probably getting eaten by those small fish. So the more I can put in at what in one go, the more chance I've got of getting some bait actually down to the bottom. Right, definitely not as many bites since we started upping the feed, but looks like we're catching better fish. Don't think this is the F1 that we're after, but it's definitely bigger than those little tiny roach. I think we might actually be getting the landing net out, in fact. I wonder if it's one of those little tiny carp that they reckon they've stocked in. Yeah, I think this is a little tiny carp. What a lovely fish. What a lovely little fish. Now, I'm guessing that is under a pound, so it'll count at the weekend, but what a beautiful fish. I tell you what, you'd hope that turned into a 30 pounder, wouldn't you? You seen that, Joe? Look how nice he is.
That's beauty,
oh, what a beautiful fish. No, just a ghost there.
Oh, there we go. I felt there was a bigger fish there then. I saw a bubble come up. And there we go, we've got another one. So I like this pinky approach, that's for sure. Just take our time. Don't count until they're in net, Father. As Dennis White once says. Look at that, another skimmer. Fantastic fishing so far. 10 ounce probably. Nice little skimmer.
Something that I'm quite wary of is I know that these lakes are quite silty, and when you start feeding a little bit too much bait, especially when you're catching some better quality fish and you're feeding smaller baits like maggots and casters, you can get quite a bit of fizzing in the peg. And obviously when you see that fizzing, loads of bubbles coming up, it's the fish disturbing the bottom, really rooting around, disturbing the bottom, disturbing the silt. It clouds up everything, and the fish, the visibility's next to nothing. The fish struggle to find your hook bait. So I've just got to be a bit wary of not feeding too much bait. I know it's a problem here in the summer months, but I'm hoping with the water temperature still on the cool side that it's not going to be too much of an issue. But the way the fish are feeding today, it seems that they want to have a bit of a munch. I'm seeing bubbles come up around the lake, and I don't really want my peg to turn into a jacuzzi, so I've just got to be a little bit wary of that. And if that does happen, it's always best to just move to the side and almost start a new line, not too far away from your original line, but just move a couple of meters to the side and start a new line, just so you're fishing on some nice fresh bottom. Another slightly better fish. I mean, it's not, I don't think I'll be breaking out the landing net. Well, I might do actually. Nice roach. Hybrid. Hybrid. 6-8 ounce maybe, 6-7 ounce.
Let's come off it and go long. I'm actually gonna put a kid in the pot on the rig as well, because I just want to tap in just a couple of maggots, a few casters maybe. Let's take that number 12 off, because I weren't happy with that. I'd rather be able to read the bite and see it develop than strike at nothings. So let's pick up this. They've got a slightly heavier rig, that 4x12 rig, which I think is probably better for decking a bait long. Let's have a look in here. Let's get a kinder pot. That's what we need. Nice little kinder pot there. Just a little cad pot. You see that? Allow me just to cup in just a couple of maggots and maybe a little pinch of worm right on the end of the pole tip. So let's just get some water in that tip. It's important that. I'm going to try a single maggot because I just think that that's always good to get me a bite on a commercial. I can catch a bit of anything on that. So I'm just going to feed two maggots and a little blob of worms. Just see what happens with that. I'm gonna go on my left hand one to start with. I've got three, but one that I've topped up, I've got my left hand one, and I've got my right hand one that I fed positive. There's a bubble just popped up. This might be a bit more of a sit and wait job, this, on these longer lines. But I know my float's rock solid in the swim. I'm bang on top of my bait. I've got not that much bait there, so if an F1 or something comes into the swim, there's a good chance I am going to hook it. There's no build up of bait on the bottom. There we go. Oh. Now then. Rob. Rob.
Yeah?
See that bow wave? No, I just struck. I think I've got an F1. And then a big carp just bow waved off the bay. That thing is an F1. Right, so I've gone on that left-hand swim, and as predicted, I've sat and waited a minute or so for a bite, and I've hooked my first decent fish, which could be an F1. Now, a big carp bow waved off my swim, which I don't think it's a carp, but it could be. Could very well be a carp. And that is the problem with worms on commercials. You know, carp love them. Now, if you were to come here in a carp match and feed worms, you probably wouldn't catch them. Which is a bit of a miracle of this sort of fishing. But let's just see if we can land him. Oh, he's come off. Now that is a bit disappointing, but it is interesting. See, it weren't foul hooked. Could have been a carp. In fact, it probably was a carp, given that that one bow waved off. But that's interesting, that. So, it may just be that worms is not the bait, so I'm just gonna pot in a couple of maggots, tiny bit of worm. I say hardly any bait, but a nice little trap for a skimmer. So, already I'm thinking, on this longer line, that a hollow elastic is probably better, an 8-hollow perhaps, something like that, just so that I can play any fish. Like, my elastic was bottom then, and that's what caused me to lose it. While that's settling, I'm just gonna try this one. Interesting, Rob's started catching odd F1s now. Here we go. Yep, F1. See, these are, they're £3. That's £2 of anybody's money. And it's not, it's actually a brown goldfish. Look at that. Lovely fish. Just single maggot, does the damage. But already I'm thinking about fishing positively rather than negatively. Because it takes a lot of rope to catch these fish, and every time I'm feeding, I'm getting an indication out there. Right, I'm having a great session here at Woodland View, and it's turning out to be very, very interesting. I expect it to be really difficult, if I'm honest. You know, everything pointed to there not being many fish to catch, a few small fish. But what's happened is I've caught roach to start with, and a bonus F1, which you saw earlier. And then, if I'm honest, the fishing got a little bit confusing, odd bubble coming up, and I just think that there were some F1s had turned up into my swim. And I've caught one short, and I've lost the carp. And then it's just gone a bit funny. Now, I can definitely catch roach on that short swim with an odd skimmer. But what's happened is I'm trying to now, I feel quite happy with that short line. I think that's gonna look after itself almost. So what I've done now, I'm trying to make my longer lines work. Now, initially I've had 3 spots, all with the same, but what I've done now, I've cancelled out the middle one. I don't think that's right. I think it's too many lines, it's getting complicated. I don't like that. So what I've done, I've got one to my left, which I'm feeding with tiny little thimblefuls, if you like, of worms, and a few maggots. And then on this one, I fed it quite positive, but now and something quite interesting is happening. Even though I fed them roughly similar, or same baits anyway, I can only catch on one. If I drop in on my left-hand one that I'm feeding very negative, with hardly any bait, it goes straight under with a skimmer on. I've had an odd brown goldfish. Yet on this one, I can't get a bite. Not an indication or anything. So, two things. One, that's the first one that I fed, so that could have been a big thing. But it's also, if you look at the lake, I'm actually going towards a corner on this right. So in my head, I feel like there's gonna be less skimmers that way than there is that way. But still fancy it for an odd bite, but it's just not happening. So what I've done, I've swapped it to feeding maggots with the hope of maybe catching an F1 or two. I'm on it now. I've just potted in like 10 maggots. I've done it like 3 times now. So I'd expect there to be an odd fish starting to move there, but there's an indication now. That's the first indication I've had on this swim. So I fed it, like I say, 3 times with 10 maggots now. So I'd expect something to start happening. But of course, I feel like I could drop in on that left-hand one. You see bubbles, it's totally different. Not a single bubble or anything. Oh, there we go. Got one on maggots. Well, that's good. That's really good. I like that. Looks like a skimmer again. Still 5 elastic. Nice and soft, doing a job. But if I can get 2 lines going out there, then that's even better, because what I'll do now, I'll feed that one and go on that one and hope that one's ready for me to catch a skimmer. Yeah, it's definitely a skimmer. They're nice fish, I must say. They're averaging about 1.5 to 2 pounds sort of size. So that's just... because you're fishing, you know, far out, a nice soft elastic helps make any mistakes. There we go, nice skimmer. Pound and a bit maybe. See him there. But that's nice, like I've got one now off that second swim, which is interesting. This is the only problem when you start feeding multiple lines. You sometimes don't get a handle on exactly what's going on. But when they're big fish like this, remember my target was only going to be to get to double figures. I've got that now, I should think. I've had 6 or 7 skimmers, an F1, a brown goldfish. There we go. Another skimmer. Lovely fishing. So what I'm doing, I'm setting 2 different traps here, and if you can get both of them to work for you, so I'll go out and feed this one now, and then that one hopefully will be ready for me to go in and catch another skimmer. It can work against you, but when there's fish to be caught like there is today, then it can be a nice little way of just ticking over and hopefully avoid any dead spells. This is where a long landing net comes in, because as you can see, that skimmer's way out, so I've got a 4 meter handle today. Just allows me to pan them fish nicely. Nice skimmer again, like peas in a pod, just over 1 pound I should think. Nice fish. Right, we're heading towards the end of our practice session now. It's been a really, really good day, to be honest. It's been very, very worthwhile coming with Rob. Rob's learnt loads on that lake. I've learnt an absolute stack of info on this lake. The biggest thing for me has been how good the fishing's actually been. I know we're sat on our own, but there's a lot more quality fish to be caught than I think either of us thought, to be honest with you. And I've just made a bit of a tactical switch. I fish longer with worms, and the pegs come alive, to be honest. I'm catching loads of skimmers. I'm catching a few carp as well, but I just think everything in the lake wants to eat the more positive baits. So all I'm doing, I'm just putting in tiny amounts of chop worm, casters, a few maggots. I'm fishing a red maggot on the hook. Still light rigs. But I'm fishing at 16 metres. I put a new line in, 16 metres, just to start again. And I'm fish feeding it, positive, feeding worms every chuck in. And like I say, just that single red maggot on the hook. Still that 4x12 float seems best. 6 elastic I've gone up to now, because I'm catching so many quality fish, it's just seems pointless using anything else. Also loose fed a few casters still on this, but to be honest, the pinkies have gone out the window now. There's too many quality fish in here to think about that. The same goes for maggots. I just don't, apart from a hook bait, loose feeding maggots just doesn't seem to be the one. So for me, it's turning into a bit of a simple match. You know, it's going to be a long pole with worms, 1 or 2 lines, and then casters short. These skimmers are so big, they're a pound and a half each. Odd F1, odd brown goldfish with a few roach mixed in. And I've probably got 30 pounds today, which would be a great weight on Saturday. Absolutely fantastic. There we go, another fish on the worm. Don't know what it is, but the pegs just transformed since I've done this. Real positive fishing. I'm really happy with what I'm doing now. It's a nice way to fish, this is. What we got? Could be an F1. 6 elastics working nicely. Something silver looking. Oh, look at that thing. Look at him, big hybrid, beautiful fish.
Look at that,
it's a clonking fish. We like a bit of him. Look at that, beauty. as you can see, everything's big now. Everything's a pound that I'm catching. Just putting together a good weight in, you know, every time I come back, I'm putting a pound in the net.
What I'd like to do is just show you the two ways of actually presenting the rig into the swim. The first way is to lay the rig out and let it fall on a tight line. Now, this is a great way for actually attracting a bite. I always feel that when that hook bait falls on a tight line, it falls much slower. The downside of this is, and hopefully I can show you now, is that you attract the attention of nuisance fish. Small roach and smaller fish like to feed higher up in the water, which means, forget rid of that stick, which means that there's more chance of you attracting one of those small fish. There you go. Just as it's settled, we've got a roach. Okay, it's not a bad size, but we want to be catching bigger fish. So I think the best way of presenting the rig into the swim when you've got loads of these small roach around is to dump it into the peg. Now, by that I mean ship out to actually where you loose fit, where you actually want to fish, and just put your hook bait in straight away and then drop your float right on top of where your hook bait has entered the peg. That way the rig falls super fast. You hopefully escape the attention of any of those smaller fish, and in theory, next bite we get, we should be attached to a better fish. That's the theory. Let's hope we can put it into practice. So the other way of presenting your rig into the peg is to just dump it in. Simply just drop your hook bait in and follow it with your float. Your rig will fall in a real messy heap, but in actual fact, it falls really fast towards the bottom, which means you should be escaping all the attention of those nuisance fish. In theory, that means the next bite should come from a better quality fish. I'd like to do this when, as I say, you're getting a lot of bites on the drop from nuisance fish and you're just not maximising your fishing time. So let's see if the proof's in the pudding, see if we can get a bite from a better quality fish. So there you go, dump the rig into the swim, and we're hooked to a better fish already. Nice bream. And to be fair, today I'm catching a lot of F1s. This is the first bream of the day, but what a weight builder. Now, if I was in a match situation, that is worth a lot of roach. So there you go, two ways of presenting the bait into the swim and two totally different results.
Single red maggot seems a nice hook bait. I feel like I'm gonna go out there and get a bite, which is really important. If, you know, if I maybe fished a piece of worm, double cast or something like that. There we go, there's another one. Really good fishing. Just potting in tiny bits of worm in. Catching good quality silvers. This one could be a carp maybe. Yeah, I think this is a carp. Got to play them all though, because every now and again it'll be an F1. And F1's accounting on Saturday, so I can't just can't get carried away and pull the heads off, just in case. This is why I've stepped up to the 6 elastic, just so I can play these bigger fish just a little bit harder. And, you know, even if it is a carp, and get it in a bit quicker. And just fish through them. See, this one's a carp. I can feel its head banging. Common. Lovely fish, just shame it doesn't count. Right, that's going to be me for that long pole. I'm going to call it a day. I'm going to have a little look on this caster short and just see what happens there for 5 minutes. And then we'll have a catch up with Rob and see what he's got on with in the van.
Right, so practice over, Rob. What do you think?
What do I think?
Caught some fish, haven't we?
We've caught some fish.
What do you think I've had? About £30 maybe?
Yeah, easy. Considering what we've messed around with today, and I have
I have messed around a lot today. I've hardly fished, to be fair.
Yeah.
I think you've had 30 pound.
Yeah, which would be mega, wouldn't it?
That would be amazing on your lake. If you can catch 30 pound on Saturday. If you can catch 30 pound on Saturday, I will moonwalk into the cave after the match.
Right, okay.
I'll moonwalk into the cave after the match.
There you go, you've got it, peeps.
And I've had literally a bite every chuck, but the trouble has been
a lot of small fish.
A lot of small fish trying to find those better quality fish. Now, it was clear that once I upped the feed, there was better quality fish to be had. Probably didn't see on the camera, but later on, I've come short, really ploughed in feed.
Yeah.
And
caught some better fish.
Caught some skimmers. I'd have one doing that. That could be a way. I'm thinking now for Saturday, I'm going to tap in my maggots at the start, take it easy. I'm going to have some corn on the subs bench.
Yep.
Because I think with that new stocking of ghosty F1s, I didn't even know it was an F1. It's a ghost F1 pot, yep. Beautiful fish.
There
might be some cornfish to be had.
Yeah.
So if I'm getting played by a little fish again on maggots, and I've tried up in the feed and they won't bugger off.
You've got some corn in your locker.
I've got some corn in my locker. Whack a few grains of corn in, tap a few grains of corn in, fish it out, I've been fishing the maggots. And then later on, maggots out at the end, 5 metres.
Whatever.
Bang, bang, bang. £20 last half hour, thank you very much.
Yeah, thanks for coming.
Yeah, thank you very much. What are you thinking?
Quite a mixed day, because to be fair, I've caught on everything I've done.
Right.
It's
been loads better than we thought it's been.
Loads better. Loads better. Obviously started on pinkies, which to be fair was good. Catching a lot of better fish that I didn't expect to catch at all. Skimmers.
Yeah.
Hard to write it off really as a starter, just to get your match going. Because I thought it'd just be tiny roach, but to be fair, it wasn't. So that was good, and then I've moved out. I've tried to be a bit complicated, really, which didn't like me at all, is it? Fishing three lines long.
Way too complicated.
Which was, to be fair.
It fried my brain as soon as I seen you do it.
Was very complicated. But it was only what I'd been told, that you know you could only catch a fish off a line and to move, so I thought it was worth trying. Soon ruled it out, to be fair. And then caught down one hole, really, just feeding worms. And that was really, really good. Odd carp as well, which obviously don't count, which was a bit of a nightmare, but...
Yeah, but if you plough through them carp...
There were skimmers to be caught.
Yeah.
And I'm sure on the day there'll be gangs of F1s as well to be caught in areas.
Right.
Didn't catch anything on Caster Short though, so I'm thinking I might fish maggots, to be fair.
Yeah.
Because you think it creates a bit more competition in your peg.
No, I fished casters last time I was on Arles, caught a few. Sure. Felt it was okay at the time, but looking at it today, I'm thinking maggots could be the killer. Maggots could be the one.
Especially with F1s counting.
Yeah.
I think maggots short. And then worms long for me is going to be my route.
Well, listen, let's just hope it works on Saturday.
Yeah, that's the only thing in it, because obviously pleasure fishing is slightly different.
Pleasure fishing is totally different.
So, folks, we'll let you know how we get on. Hopefully, with £2,000. In the bank account.